Hello and welcome to How Not to Play, the channel where I play video games badly. Today we are going to be continuing our Platinum playthrough of Final Fantasy VII Rebirth. A quick note as we're going through this video, if you catch anything that I have done incorrectly or could have done better or just completely missed, please feel free to put it in the description below. I do want these to be as close to a 100% walkthrough as possible. While you're down there, go ahead and put a like on this video. It really helps to push these out into the algorithm and grow the channel. Also, please hit that subscribe button if you want to get notifications of any future videos in this series. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and get into some gameplay.
There's nothing here, you know.
Alright, so let's go ahead and help out around town now that we've got everything else done. Oh, we've got two boards now. Darling little cat. Chocobos. We'll go ahead and do Esoteric Secrets. Now, let's go ahead and do my white-haired angel. Darn little cat, because that's right here in Nibelheim, so we don't have to go too far for that. So let's go find this lady's cat. At my house. Or what used to be my house.
Isn't really mine, though.
Hello, dear. May I help you?
Just listening. You've got a great voice.
Oh, you flatter me. I didn't even know I was doing it. You see, this cat I feed sometimes has gone missing. And when I worry, I cannot help but see.
That is the weirdest neurosis I've ever heard.
Sounds like a job for a merc, doesn't it?
I'm worried, so I'm gonna sing happily. What? Anyway. Sure, let's...
Why, I sing whenever the mood strikes, really. Haven't you ever felt like bursting into song?
No,
I can't say I have.
That's not normal.
You've got an ear for music, though.
I played piano a little when I was younger. My mom taught me.
Why, that's lovely. You want to accompany me sometime?
Sure. I bet it'd be a lot of fun.
Come on.
If you like, we can go look for your cat.
Really? Oh, what a relief. I'm Christine, by the way. Chef and chanteuse. You might want to start by looking around the foot of Mount Nebel. She's got the most beautiful snow-white coat. Petite little thing, too. Speaking of, she must be starving out there. Here, be sure to feed her.
Your cat just runs off up the mountain? What the heck? So, yeah, we're gonna have to go... I haven't even been over that way. I'm not even sure how to get over that way.
All this talk of cats makes me think of Fluffy.
Yeah, the one and only. What happened to her, anyway?
No idea. Haven't seen her since the fire 5 years ago.
Yeah.
I can't shake the feeling that I just left her to die. I really hope she's okay, but if she's not...
I mean, I kind of hate to say this, but... I mean, your cat is very resilient, and I'm sure it's okay. In fact, it might even be the same cat that we're going after now.
What?
How come you named your cat Fluffy? It's not like her fur was long or super soft or anything.
Well, to be fair, I wasn't the one who named her. The mayor gave her to me as a gift for my 12th birthday. When he put her in my arms, he said, "This little lady's name is Fluffy," but he never explained why. Don't get me wrong, I was dead set on giving her a better name. But before I could, everyone had already started calling her Fluffy. And the more I heard it, the more I thought, well, maybe it's not that bad. So I let it stick. I wasn't much of a fighter back in those days. Hard to believe looking at me now. Hey, do you remember that red bandana Fluffy always had around her neck?
Now that you mention it.
Believe it or not, my dad made it. With cloth from one of his old shirts. Even though she was my cat, I think he took better care of her.
That right.
Sorry, didn't mean to bring him up.
No need to apologize.
What's up?
Heard something. Over there. Let's go.
So yeah, as you go out of Nibelheim, just kind of head off to the east over that little bridge there, and right about the time you hit this little pass here, we catch sight of Fluffy, who of course runs off through a monster field.
Gotcha.
Whoa, that is more than one cat. I guess we know what they've been doing out here.
Kittens? I can't believe it. Fluffy? Hey, girl. How you doing? It's me, Tifa. Remember? You're okay. Thank God. Fluffy, what's wrong?
She doesn't look so good.
Let's try giving her the cat food. There's plenty more where this came from, so dig in.
Oh wow, that's a lot of bees. Weak to fire, exploding that will pressure them. And it looks like we follow Fluffy down to more bees.
Let's move.
We're rescuing Fluffy's kittens now from the bees. And now we're all running back to town. Don't go into the bees, you stupid cat. Yeah.
Don't give up.
You're up.
Not all the times.
Fluffy and the kittens might have been hurt. Do you mind if we head back to the village? You know, if we asked her nicely, I bet that head chef would take care of the kittens. I mean, can't say no to both of us, right?
Guess we'll see. Come on.
Stray too far from Fluffy and they'll lose their way. Keep track of the kittens and stay close. So our job is literally herding cats. We're literally herding cats. Oh, Lord. Are they actually going to follow me, though? Okay, so they are actually following me. As long as I don't go too fast. Where am I going? Off this way. Alright, we made it back to the Nibelheim. Just kind of walk it. Fluffy will follow you, the kittens will follow her. If you go off into a run, you'll lose them and have to basically start over. But now that they're here, they should head back to the kitchen.
I feel so bad. Huh. Guess even she can tell this place is nothing like it used to be.
That's probably why she never came back here.
What is it?
Somebody's playing your piano.
After him.
Alright. Oh, welcome. I'm afraid the staff is on break at the moment. If you're looking for Christine, she's upstairs.
Playing Tifa's theme on Tifa's piano.
You might have noticed how some of our patients have number tattoos on their arms. Why, look who it is. Oh, my little baby! I'm so glad you're okay. And just look at all these yummy muffins you brought back with you.
She gave birth to her litter on the mountain.
Oh, sweetling, you're going to be a great mommy.
I hope this is all right. It wasn't exactly safe for a bunch of kittens. Couldn't just leave them, so...
Don't be silly, dear. You did the right thing. I'll take excellent care of this family. They'll want for nothing.
Long I've dreamed of opening my home to little ones to play and romp and love. La 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 la. If I'm going to take these cats in, they're going to need names. You've got such beautiful white fur. Blanca. Yes, that fits perfectly, don't you think? As for the kittens, we'll decide later.
Actually, the cat's already got a name.
Shh. What? You weren't hoping to hear me play, were you? I'm terribly sorry, Blanca, but I'm a bit worn out after all that excitement.
Tifa can play.
Cloud? What a wonderful idea. You'll humor us, dear, won't you?
Okay. Just a bit.
Hold that thought. This occasion calls for an accompaniment. I know some folks who would just love the chance to perform. Don't go anywhere.
That escalated quickly. I wasn't expecting an audience. I haven't practiced since I was a kid. What should I do?
Back out?
Well, that's not an option.
Then I think you better get warmed up.
Oh, we actually have to play. Yeah, this was not what I expected either, Tifa. Don't worry about it. Oh, we got Aerith's theme for this. Oh, nice. All right, well, let's practice that, because I haven't played this song yet. So cool that you get to play with as Tifa. Oh, geez, they're all right here in the room. Not bad.
The cats for me?
I certainly will. Rest assured, I'll keep them very well fed. So bring your appetites. All right, come along then.
Playing that piano again brought back a lot of memories. How Mom used to teach me while Dad was downstairs in the kitchen doing his best, which was pretty good. Hangouts with Emilio and the gang. Which we kept inviting you to, but you never came.
Never? Really?
Really, but you seemed fine on your own.
That what it looked like? That I enjoyed being alone?
You didn't?
Of course not.
Huh. Guess we still don't know each other that well.
Well, never too late to make up for lost time.
Yeah. That's true. I'm glad we came.
Yeah. Glad we found Fluffy, too.
I think you mean Blanca. But yeah, I hope she and the kittens are happy here.
I was not expecting that quest to end in a piano recital.
I'm not sure why that is myself. Maybe it's to mark ones with different symptoms?
Down here in the main foyer, we should have...
We provide checkups.
Yep, there's our little guy who's always somewhere near a piano.
There's no finer sound in all the world than the voice of a humble piano.
Yep, and we get Aerith. Wait, oh, missed one? What did I miss? Don't know the place I've been is Cosmo. Maybe there's something in Cosmo.
Mellifluous melodies are all the more pleasing when played on the piano. Thank you for sharing such joy with the world. I hope you will enchant us with even more splendid performances in time.
Yeah.
If you're here to visit someone, I'm afraid you'll have to track them down yourself. We're a bit busy. We've been dealing...
All right, well, we can't fast travel out to Cosmo Canyon yet. But we'll head over that way and figure out that piano thing that we missed. For now, let's go ahead and see what we can do with the Chocobo Sage. Chocobos are lovely creatures. They can be a handful if you don't know proper techniques. I offer personal training. Sign up now for a special course, which includes 3 meals, afternoon naps, and a luxurious pool open all hours of the day. All right. Sure. The Chocobo Sage was instrumental in the Chocobo breeding program that you had in the original Final Fantasy game. There he is. So we did kind of stumble on him a little bit when we were exploring. But here is Chocobo Sage's Manor, just kind of off that main, inlet there. So we'll go ahead and fast travel down there, or just take your Chocobo down to this area, if you haven't been there yet. And I wonder if he'll teach us how to, breed racing Chocobos like he did in the original. All right, so here he is. Yep, right by his pool.
Huh? Cloud?
Wait, Chuckle Billy?
Billy? What are you doing out here?
I haven't had much luck at the racetrack lately. Not the good kind, that's for sure. So I came here to train.
Train? Here?
You don't know where you are? This is the home of the Chocobo Sage, a living legend. Surely you've heard of the man.
Did someone say living legend?
Not for long, it seems.
You okay, sir?
I am now. Thought I was a goner.
Huh?
Mind telling me who you are? You don't get many visitors out here in the boonies.
This is Cloud. He's a jockey for Gramps' ranch.
Oh, he is, huh? Perfect. Billy here needs some help. He can pick up the poor boy's slack.
There's this big race at the Saucer, the Gold Cup, and it's coming up soon. We gotta get in on that, so I came here to bone up. I'm learning all sorts of stuff. See?
Hey. Tell me you're not buying this choco dung. Picking garbage out of a pool isn't training. It's manual labor. You see it too, right?
I mean... I would agree with you, Yuffie, but... I have seen The Karate Kid. So it's possible there could be some underlying training going on. But yeah, it is pretty weird.
So weird. Come on, he's just jerking you around.
I suppose I haven't done much to pick up after him.
If you can flap your gums, you can move your gams. Now get on back to your training.
Sorry!
As for you, I know just the thing. One of my chocobos ran off when we put her out to pasture. Need you to find her. Bring her back.
You're asking me?
Her name is Selena. Ain't your normal chocobo neither. Loves the ocean more than home. The way she makes rolling waves look like solid ground. No wonder she thinks she's the bee's knees.
Please, Cloud, would you mind? Just think of it as a favor for me. You've got a gift for wrangling the wild ones.
A bird that runs on water? I already found him.
There you are, Selena. Well, I underestimated you. Takes real skill to tame this girl. Skills like those of... Hold on. I know this. I do. Why can't I remember? God damn it! This is gonna bother me all day. Oh. Aha! There we go. It was Sam and Will.
What?
They were far and away my best disciples. As I was saying, you, Cloud, you may well become as talented a trainer as them one day.
Did I hear you right? Sam? You gotta tell me everything you know about it.
You're gonna give me whiplash, son.
The Sam guy you taught. You mean Chocobo Sam out of Midgar?
I do, but why do you want to know?
Because me and him, we got history. You see, I'm Will's son.
Well, don't that beat all? I'll never forget those two. They had such a powerful passion, and an eagerness to learn, too. Everything they did was for the birds.
That's not the Sam I know. Sam's a demon. He led my parents to an early grave. Got them hooked on gambling. Pushed them to rack up tons of debt. And then...
That don't sound like him to me. You sure you ain't got your Sams mixed up? It's a common name, you know.
Only one Sam in this business. I swore that I'd humiliate him by winning the Gold Cup. Destroy his reputation. Then I'd at least have some kind of revenge for what that bastard did to my parents.
Now that that's out of your system, back to it.
Excuse me?
You heard me. Thought you came out here to learn about chocobos, not to get revenge. Cloud, for your next task, I'll need you to take Selena and gather choco grass, which so happens to grow above bodies of water.
You kidding me? This fossil's trying to get us to do his dirty work again?
Choco grass is a genuine panacea. I kid you not. It'll cure whatever ails you, and then some. And once I am cured, maybe I'll be inclined to share more stories about the good old days.
He's obviously full of it.
If not for him, then please do it for me. I need to know what happened to my dad.
Okay.
When I said it grows above water, I meant above. It's called the floating flower, because it grows in the air. But with an ocean chocobo, you can harvest the stuff with ease. 30 tufts ought to do. Best hop to it, Cloud. You don't want my death on your hands, do you?
Well, I have been collecting some, but 30? I don't have that much. Alright, well, guess we're going. So here in your key items, you can see the choco grass that we have already collected. I've got 16 just from being out and about. So let's go ahead and find ourselves 14 more. I don't know why this guy needs freaking 30 of these things. So basically just travel to anywhere with water and look for these little tufts hanging up above the water line. And just use your choco jet to kind of bounce around to collect them. and do that for, I don't know, probably about a half hour or so. Or until you get 30.
That's a decent amount of choco grass, I suppose. Well, what do you think? Should we take it back to the sage?
I think so. So after we've collected all 30, we can head on back up to Master Roshi, the Chocobo Sage.
Oh, you get your hands on that Choco Grass.
All right, well, we've got all 30 Choco Grass, so let's go ahead and shove it in his face.
Well, well, if it ain't my beloved Choco Grass. This stuff can be one hell of a hassle to gather. Thank goodness I had you to get it for me.
Okay, so what are you gonna do with it?
I suppose you've earned the right to know. First, I take this fluff, mix it with some chocobo feathers, and let it ferment. Once it's dry, I boil it all down. Then I squeeze it all out and voila, my patented choco tincture.
That's some kind of magic medicine?
Oh no, just a little fun.
This wrinkly, cheeky old...
Speaking of grass, if you've got some extra tufts on hand, would you mind sharing them with my assistant at the shop? I promise I'll make it worth your while.
Please, tell me about my father.
Halter Chocobo's son, there's still one thing you need to do for me first.
What a surprise. This geezer isn't gonna tell you jack. Face it, kid.
You got a lot of nerve. Casting aspersions. After all the wisdom I've shared.
All the what now?
So you haven't realized you've been training this whole time? Tracking down Selena forced you to get in touch with the Chocobo's feelings. And all that running across the water you did helped hone your sense of balance and your bird handling. Key skills for any aspiring jockey. What do you say, Cloud? Bet you feel like a real Choco Pro by now.
Can't say I do.
Sounds to me like you need more training. Reckon we ought to add one more item to your regimen. Think of it as a final trial of sorts.
Oh, give me a break. Don't go changing the subject here, Gramps. We're not doing your stupid trial.
No, it's fine. I'll do it.
Then it's settled. I'll be your opponent. And dear Selena will be your steed.
If Cloud wins, does that mean you'll finally tell me about my dad?
You've got a deal. But know that I won't be pulling any punches out there. When you're ready, give me a holler and we can hit the track.
Oh, it's a race. Let's see. We do have a Choco Grass collector.
You got any Choco Grass for me? Now how about plumes?
So what do we do here with 35 tufts, we get a golden plume, that's worth it. 40, we get an otherworldly crystal. 45, we get Galar Horn for, And for 50, we get... Oh, so the 30 that we gave him already count. Okay, so this is just 5 more, 10 more, so 20 more tufts. And we can get all of these. That's not too bad. Yeah, we can do that. As for plumes, we can go ahead and trade those in for Saurian gear. Those look pretty wicked. Ever wanted to turn your chocobo into a dinosaur? There you go. Alright, so what's this race gonna be? We're gonna have to collect Choco Grass plumes, aren't we?
You
You prepared to undertake the final trial?
Zoom, De Chocobo. Sure. Oh, it's like an actual race. Might have to do this a few times since I don't really remember how to do this. Damn, he's fast. Look at these little zoomers. Yeah. Fire at him. Yep. That's funny. I can just shoot a bubble at him, that is great. Maybe it won't take a whole lot of practice.
Pluck my ever-loving feathers. That was one hell of a performance. If I didn't know better, I'd say this wasn't your first rodeo.
Surprise.
Well, shoot. You got me good. And once you start tearing up the track out there, the racing world will blame me for letting you loose.
A promise is a promise, sir. Please tell me more about my dad and Uncle Sam.
All right, then. What do you want to know?
All right, so let's hear some backstory here on the Chocobo family.
Let's see. They couldn't have been much older than you are now. The two of them came and asked me to take them under my wing. Turned them down, seeing as I'd already retired. But they hung around the grounds anyway. Since they had nothing better to do, I put them to work. And that's how it all began. Well, wasn't nothing out of the ordinary, I'd say. Ran some errands, did some repairs, helped around the house. You know, your standard training regimen. And in their downtime, they took it upon themselves to dig through my library, learning about chocobos and how to handle them. Came to differing conclusions. They used to argue something fierce.
Oh? What about?
I can't say the two of them got on terribly well.
I figured.
Will and Sam had mighty strong opinions about how to best raise chocobos, and it drove them to fight. With their words, and with their fists. That said, Only reason those two fought as hard as they did is because they both cared deeply about the cause. As far as passion is concerned, the two of them were birds of a feather. How you feel now? Managed to sort out the mess inside?
What do you mean?
When we first met, I saw the way your eyes were brimming with anger. I knew right then and there that what you needed wasn't teaching or training. What you needed was time. Time to look deep inside yourself and clear out all the wickedness and spite that have been haunting your heart.
Which is why you had him clean out the pool?
Exactly. I don't know what happened to your father after he left this place. And I can understand why he'd want to beat old Sam in a race. Few things feel better than sticking it to someone who did you wrong. But that being said, you should never use your birds as tools for revenge. Ask yourself, why did I decide to start raising chocobos?
I guess it's because I saw how happy those birds made my mom and dad. How they'd smile. The chocobos brought us a lot of fun, and brought us together as a family. I guess that's why.
Good enough. The why is important, so don't forget yours. I reckon Sam's got his eyes on the gold cup. Keep yours unclouded by hatred, and you'll do fine.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for everything. I'm gonna head back to the saucer. Make sure our birds are ready for the big race. Don't worry about putting your name in. I'll take care of it. All you need to do is show up and win.
I never said I was gonna race for you, buddy. This is your beef. You race it. I mean, I will. But that's beside the point. Alright, looks like I've got some more choco grass to collect before I move on. Because Kate Sith needs a new megaphone. In our quest for choco grass, we did find a new cache location here called the Nidog Grotto. It's just kind of a little cave here that's got three treasure chests in it. Hardest part about it is finding it. As we can see, it's just kind of right here. If you go in this little inlet here, there's this little spot in there. And it's just kind of right on the way. Little piece of choco grass there. And once again, the choco grass took us to Stowaway Cove here on the bottom of the map, where we've got a couple chests hidden behind some crates. So we just go ahead, knock the crates over, get our chests. There's supposed to be a third one. Oh, there it is. I just missed it. Yeah, once again, kind of the hardest part is finding it. So it looks
like... You got
like,
any choco grass for me?
The choco grass are in...
I'll be here. Now how about blooms?
Static locations throughout the world. They do not respawn. So you might need to get yourself a guide or a map or a tutorial to show you where all the different areas are. I did get one of these maps and went to all 50 spots and still missed two. So they're inside caves, they're out in the open, they're just anywhere water is at. So feel free to do that. Get yourself all 50. 45 is the major landmark, though. That gets you the weapon for Kate Sith. Cleansing materia earrings are just kind of a bonus.
Good luck out there.
The big payout here is the Galar Horn for Kate Sith and the Lady Luck ability. Call upon the Goddess of Fortune to increase crit hit rate. Proficiency bonus, just activate on all three of your party members. So yeah, that should be pretty easy to do. So I believe that kind of does it for the Nibble region. Like I said, there are those two more tufts of chocograss to find, but I'm not really worried about that. Aside from that, we've pretty much been everywhere, done everything, and I think it's time to head on back to the airport and see who is calling Sid.
In response to last night's illegal broadcast by the SRC, President Rufus
apparently Sid is calling himself.
In it, the president did not.
Hey!
Stood up?
Nope. Waiting on you folks. Something I wanted to ask. About your mother. Her name's Ifalna, right?
Maybe. So what?
That sounds like a yes to me.
I called it the second I saw you.
Boy, am I ever glad I sent up smoke. Tell me, how's she doing? Good?
No. She's dead.
You know, the whole reason I joined Shinra was to become a pilot. But I wound up as a gopher for some lazy grease monkeys. Had me running around HQ fixing lights and whatnot. One time, though, I came across a pretty young thing with a little girl in her arms. That was you, wasn't it?
Probably.
You were knee-high to a Tonberry. I was what? Called a smogger, I'd wager. But damn. No longer with us. That's a crying shame. Truly. Hey, Missy.
It's Aerith.
Aerith, is there anything I can do for you? I want to help.
What? Why?
Just trying to do right by you.
Flying us around will be more than plenty. Thanks.
Then again, if you're just dying to help, you could take us to the saucer for free.
Free?
It's fine. We'll pay.
Nah, it's on me. When you want to head to the saucer, just give me a holler.
I mean, that's kind of why we came here, was because we need to go to the saucer.
Hey, good to go. Let's get a move on, then.
An 8?
Huh?
You said that Sephiroth is your foe.
I have a history with him. Unfinished business.
He bothering you? Want me to give him the boot?
Try to screw us over, and you're a dead man.
Please, take a seat.
Do you think you can manage 8?
Ain't gonna lie. That's a tall order for most pilots. Lucky for you, I ain't most pilots. Can swim away from.
You almost killed us.
Thank you for watching this video. If you made it this far, you might as well go ahead and hit that like button. It really helps push the channel out into the algorithm and helps it grow. Also, please hit that subscribe button to be notified of any future installments in this series and any future series that I do. Once again, I just want to say thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.